since the company has transitioned from POP data storage company to data management company, how are you kind of conveying this message to not only customers but your partners as well across this region?
Right, so I think, NetApp's own transformational strategy is very much to be the leader in the hybrid cloud data services. And we are the data authority, leader in the data management. Over the last 1 year, we have been making very deliberate communications through our marketing engine, as well as the field team, the leadership team across the whole organizations, sharing that with our customers and our partners to make sure that they understand right the journey that NetApp has transformed into, the leadership positions that we are garnering now as a leader for the hybrid cloud solutions.
So any specific effort or programs that has been designed so that this messaging goes out to the larger base of partners you have across this region?
In fact, I think first and foremost, I talk about the strategy, right? Certainly, NetApp, we want to be the leader in the hybrid cloud data services. And aligning to that, go-to-market strategy is very much to anchor the growth areas. And the growth areas for us, we call it Big Three, right? Which is very much to anchor Flash, HCI, as well as the cloud volume, right? So we have communicated this strategy and the whole growth opportunities that we are seeing across our partner community. It was a very deliberate, face-to-face meeting. It was to communications. And also, we want to make sure that our partners do understand so that they are aligned with our growth strategy. They do have a plan and commitment to want to grow in the market and address all these opportunities together with us. Yeah.
So, when you talk about your Big Three, that's correct. In fact, they're also not aligned with the machine learning, some AI, IoT, so of the world. While in India, we explained that there are very few select partners who are actually working in the cloud domain, but the largest centers still kind of not evaluated, but they're not enough fixed whether that will really benefit them in the long run. And the same goes for other new emerging technologies as well. So is it the case across this market or other market, be it China or Australia or any other country, are mature and in comparison to the Indian partners?
I think my observation is that the enterprise cloud adoption rate actually varies market to market. And hence, both, if we look at the progress that our channel partners have made, it also varies country to country, right? But what is clear is that because of our leadership positions in the hybrid cloud data services, we are in a unique position to help our channel partners to better position themselves, to build their customer relationship, and to quickly accelerate some of this momentum, right, and engagement that they have into business outcomes, for everyone. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I believe that you must have interacted with the Indian partners as well in the past. So do you think that Indian partners kind of practices they have in terms of running the business, in terms of approaching the customer requirements. Is there any similarity or difference do you see when you compare it with other markets?
Right. So I would say, generally our partners actually take the customer first approach. Mm-hmm. Right. And what I mean by that is many times they want to first understand the external and the internal challenges that our customers are going through. What are their business objectives in this digital transformation world?
country, the citizens of the world. When you interact with them, do you think that they follow some kind of best practices which can be replicated by partners of other markets or across to Asia Pacific or even to other markets as well?
Right. So our partners like such as people and HCL, they differentiate again, you know, talk about differentiation. Their approach to the customers is very much to the managed services, right? Which is very much their strength. And they leverage on that to offer more of a business outcome service offering approach to the customers. Because this is an area where you have the opportunity to basically position more services and support. And this is where our partners have the opportunity to be a lot more profitable. Yeah. So I think it's a good, you know, an area of strength of the partners that many other partners in the regions would like to emulate and would like to be in a similar position.
Momentum that when these partners come together and they kind of interact, talk to each other, and kind of get insights from their experiences and maybe start replicating the same in their own markets.
So, certainly, we created lots of opportunities, you know, such as here in India. We will have our partner summit once a year where we invite all our key partners to join us for the sessions. And it's not just hearing what NetApp has got to say, right? More important is create a forum for our partners to network, interact, and there are always opportunities for them to learn one another's best practices, and sometimes they could leverage each other's strengths to partner, right, within a market or in the region. We also have instances where we create, in fact, part of my district, we have executive dialogue with our partners. You know, yesterday was at Chennai, and here today at Mumbai, we are have an executive dialogue with a group of partners. So through this interaction and networking, which is very deliberate, we want to bring the partners together to interlock and learn from one another.
So similar kind of partner summits are organized in other markets as well?
Yes, very much so.
But I want to understand that is there any platform where all these partners are different markets of decision? There's an annual platform where they come together from partners of India, China, and then they discuss and exchange notes as we say. So do you have any such platform as such?
So from a technical forum perspective, we have our insights when we go once a year. We gather partners around the world, right? At one location where we share the latest and the greatest technologies and information and case studies, use cases, so that all the different partners across the globe, right, will learn from one another. Yeah, this, I would say, is very much a flagship program that NetApp has. We have it, we organize it every year in two key locations in US as well as in EMEA.
So NetApp in India, when we last spoke, we talked about a partner academy, maybe in India they reach out to tier 2, 3 cities and interact with partners on a basis. So is there a similar kind of academy that you've been seeing there with the markets as well?
Yes, we place a lot of emphasis on partner enablement, right? It's important for us to invest in their skill sets and capabilities. So partner academies, we have it here in India. In fact, we have it across the globe, right? And at the same time, besides having partner academies, we also have other very comprehensive programs such as the NetApp technical training and certifications.
the existing program that we have at this point in time.
So, currently, our program, our sales program very much encompasses solutions, right? Teaching and conveying the messages on solutions from across the focus area that NetApp has. We also talk about use cases, we talk about customer needs. This amounts of value selling very much help our partners sales to elevate the whole conversations with our target customers, right? And to be in a position to not talk about product or solutions to kickstart the conversation, but to really anchor the conversation, starting with understanding the customer's challenges, right? The business requirement, the objective, what are they trying to solve in terms of their business challenges? So taking that conversation to a very, very different level, yeah, and learning the product and the solutions to be more of a natural evolution from that conversation.
When you're in Japan, I mean, this was like yesterday in Chennai. Mm-hmm. So what sort of feedback are we receiving in terms of the technology, the challenges they are facing? So is there any, I can say, uniqueness in which you see that this is one area which has not been touched upon till now, and you would like to address it as soon as possible?
Right. I think our conversations are partners, right in the future of that. They trust us that they want to continue the whole partnership with us. In fact, most of our partners have been with us for many years, right? Some are even more than a decade. So they have been through this journey with us. They have been very aligned with our focus areas. So in terms of, I would say, more of personal learning, right, it's very much the new technologies, but in the space of cloud, right, what does that mean? And I think we started all of these conversations with our partners wanting to learn more about the technologies and how it applies to them. They are looking towards that to actually train them, to actually enable their team to better understand so that they could then look at how that will translate in terms of their organization focus and capability to address the customer's transformation requirements. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So when you said about the form based learning, especially on the cloud side of it, why we are seeing that the community transformation that there are requirements happening and few partners are still doing it. But when we look at the whole larger picture, then we are seeing a lot of more in the cloud kind of new age partners who have come up and they are doing immensely good work. These are in a lot of traditional channel players who have been there.
Yes.
So what's your kind of take on it? Do you think that these new age partners will have a much better say, or they will have a fair play in the market, or and how the traditional ones have to kind of gear up so that they're up to the kind of market dynamics that is changing day in day out?
Right. So we have a multi-pronged approach, I would say, right? We do recognize there's born in the cloud partners, partners that could represent us well in the cloud solutions and offerings that we have, right? So we certainly would like the born in the cloud partners to represent that in the marketplace, right? At the same time, we want to value our partners who have been through this whole journey with us over the years, right? And for partners who have expressed their commitment, the alignment within their organizations to want to invest, to address these cloud opportunities, we want to make sure that we commit to train them and to make sure that they are able and capable of going through this whole journey with us. So we will, you know, the way we look at our go-to-market to address the cloud opportunities, we will have a mix of the cloud partners as well as the existing partners who have the cloud DNA, who have the commitment and the want to invest, right, to be able to address this big growth market opportunities.
So in this interval, there is a kind of a proper hand holding being done from the entire side for these kind of partners so that they are kind of armored to addressing the sort of requirement that's coming from the customers?
Yes, certainly the enablement training that I talk about that will apply because our training programs doesn't stop today, right? We will keep evolving to make sure that the new curriculum are relevant to what's required to address the market opportunities, to address the gap that our partners would like us to help them to acquire, right? So at the same time, you will see us launching, I would say, new programs. In fact, Cloud First program was relatively new. It was launched about 2 years ago, right? And the intention is to recruit, I would say, the Cloud First or the Cloud partners to be NetApp partners, right? At the same time, as I said, we will also look into applying the program that we have launched for the Cloud First partners or the Cloud partners to bring that and replicate that to the existing unified partners that we have.
They need to be kind of trained and able to be available for any sort of challenge that is coming up. And especially if you talk about the Indian market, it all boils down to the profitability and the margin part of it. Because while this is not a very commoditized product, where they could just sell and get something there. So has NetApp designed this rebate and incentive in such a way that that part is also kind of taken care of and they are happy at the end of the day?
Right. Certainly, I have a clear colleagues. Right? One of the fundamental key area that we need to address, right, is our partners' profitability. So, when we launch our partner programs, it's a very comprehensive one. It involves sales, marketing, service support, enablement and training. At the same time, a very critical piece of that is the incentive program. And the incentive programs, we very deliberately, in fact, last year we launched one of the industry, in fact, that has in history, the richest and programs, incentive program that we have, right, was launched 1st August last year, right? And the very comprehensive programs, not only help our partners to invest in the areas that we want them to focus on, but then giving them the opportunity to be more profitable as they reach out the solutions that we have.
So that all this cloud first program and because obviously these would be going under different iterations as and when the requirement of the market changes. So how frequently these are done, or these are set for a year and then?
Yes, it is a plan program. That being said, we do, throughout the year, as and when needed, we will make adjustments, we will make enhancements, so that we are quick, to address any change that is needed to ensure that we capture, right? Meet the attention of the customers, the attention of our partners, or to help them to invest and be profitable in any specific areas that we need to address. So it's a higher program, but at the same time, it gives us the flexibility to make enhancements throughout the year. And in fact, we deliberately see our partners' feedback right, on an ongoing basis so that we could feel the pulse of the market, what's going on in different markets across Asia Pacific, what we can do better, and so that we could enhance the program accordingly.
There was a question which I asked Kaushal also when we met last on the attrition part of it, because we can specifically see a lot of, especially the technical guys and all, they are in their own part, that the partners guys are talking about. They can train, they stick to the company for years, and the moment they get a better opportunity, or especially to some other partners. Is it the key true for the market size as well, or how is the scenario there?
I think it varies may not be their partners, maybe something different. Yeah.
So in theory, NetApp is putting in foreign and this is one big only for your partners. So you were able to kind of address replicating the same if they have any kind of policy that they follow with partners from Japan that they follow and that can be again replicated in India. Are you really trying to bridge that gap or
right. So I think there's going to be team you know collaborations and we don't understand some of the challenges that our partners might have from a NetApp perspective. Going back to the talent programs that we have, the enablement training programs that we have, we hope through this we could help to excite our partners' employees, right, from a skill set development, capability development. We want to, through this program, also motivate them to continue to be part of the, you know, NetApp startup family because they are key and important to us. When we invest and train them, we hope they will continue through this journey so that we can live together and grow the market and grow our business together.
So when you're interacting with partners, what sort of expectations have you kind of set? And what are you expecting to be your key takeaways from the meetings that you have and that you had in the past?
Right. So I think in any partnership, right, trust is very, very important. So we want to build a very mutual trusting relationship because that is the fundamental to the success of the partnership. After which then, as NetApp invest in the various programs to help our partners to be successful, we then, you know, expect and would like them to reciprocate with commitment, with the focus, with the investment, to want to really focus on the NetApp solutions and help us represent us in the marketplace, whether be in a space where we have our own sales rep or anchoring the customers or new marketplace where we have not been there, right? Because many of our partners would have the very strong relationship, customer relationship, the coverage. And sometimes it could be in the space that we are strong in, while other times it could be new areas that we have not been there, and then there is no presence. So we allow our partners to help bring us into the new space in addition to growing the existing business that we have together. Yeah.
Lastly, what sort of next big opportunities do you think your partners have and for larger picture data has for the next so by 2020 or 2022, which 5 years, where do you see the opportunity like for the data and its partners?
NetApp has set up our strategy, you know, to be a leader in the hybrid cloud and data management space. And we have also laid out our focus, which is a big trick, right? I will see a continuation of us remaining very, very focused in the strategy and the focus areas that we want to drive together with our partners, right? And that's the Flash, HCI, as well as the cloud. We will want our partners to invest today and be able to grow and garner the business growth together with us, you know, 2019, 2020, 2021. I think this will remain a focus area for us to drive growth. Of course, along the journey, NetApp will certainly, you know, as part of our leadership in innovation and in solutions, so that we have launch new solutions and enhancements that will help us to even better positions in these key growth areas that we want to embark on.
Just want to ask, NetApp also has some kind of center of excellence in India, that's where your partners get to see the live work or happening at the back end and they can kind of then get to learn from it and start addressing the requirements of the customers.
Yes, we don't have few center of excellence across the globe. Okay. I think here in India we have a large R&D center, I think 1,000 over people at Bangalore. And within that, we also have the center of excellence where we create the opportunities for our partners to have not
Yes, because like some of your very big players, they also give their partners some opportunity to set up their own center of excellences, and then they invite the, their customers to experience and feel the technology with them. That is why that has access. Provision for your company with the partners, or it is only that data owns to the CV that not really get to experience it.
So one certainly as an area which is very much also part of our partner program, right? We do have partner gear or demo gear as part of our program where we want to help partners to acquire some of this equipment and solutions. And not just that, we also want to work with them to in fact develop ecosystem solutions that they could demo in their center of excellence, in their lab environment, to the customers that we jointly have, right? So that they could be in a better position to accelerate sales, to demoing of some of these solutions that they are able to bring forward to the customers.